ask questions there. Okay, so we're going live now. Paul, have you ever heard of the Silk Road? I don't know if Paul's responding. Paul, are you there? Are you responding to us? Oh, there he goes. So, yeah, what was the Silk Road? You know what the Silk Road is, huh? So the Silk Road was a network of ancient trade routes which connected Europe and the Far East, spanning from the Yellow Sea all the way to the Korean Peninsula. It's pretty interesting, Paul. Yeah, it's pretty great. Oh, and then it also extended down to the African continent. Wait, Marco Polo traveled the Silk Road and brought back many ideas and innovations from Asia, including spaghetti and gunpowder. Huh, interesting. Okay. Whoa, what's wrong? Don't forget the silk. Yeah, you mean like in silk as in silk almond milk? Welcome to another episode of the Mighty Code Coder. I'm Rob Fitzgerald, here to make you great and help you innovate. In this episode, we are going to do work with a modeling language. Not a uniform modeling language like is synonymous with programming languages as UML, but a Mr. Lew modeling language, a MLML. Designing your class before you start coding is like brainstorming an idea or writing an outline for an essay. It is really easy to set up for your class first before you start coding. When I first started coding, I always started on the computer, but they call it a programming language for a reason. It is a true language, and you can design an application like writing an essay or a show. You can outline what is going to go on in the application without turning on the computer. So that is what we're going to do today. And I will show you how I outline the Husky Tech Player, which I've been talking about in previous videos, to start. So let's get going. All right, so before I start here, I'd like to welcome my first period class in. They are watching the show live on Google Meet. So they're watching it live on YouTube, and they're watching it live on Google Meet. So they're over this way, iClass. And anyway, they're gonna watch it both ways. I don't think you can watch it both ways. I think there's a little bit of lag there. It'd be really annoying. But check it out. See, this technology is crazy. Paul, you okay? You okay? All right. Be cool, man. Be cool. All right. So before I get going, let's go ahead and I'm gonna put that over there. I'm gonna be going to the board today to drop some stuff. So I want to go first. I want to go to I will first start with the UML for the Husky Tech Player. So as you guys were seeing, or if you saw in previous videos, this was the Husky Tech Player that we had for my classes. I was just talking to one of our educational aides that we draw Mickey Mouse on here. I showed you that we draw Mickey Mouse. But before I wrote the player, I actually did a UML. I actually wrote up what was going to be in the Husky Tech Player first. And this is what a UML is. So if you see this Husky Tech Media Player, it has, these are the classes that I have. I have a splash page, an in player, a player, an HTML. And you can see that I post what are going to be the variables, the instance variables. But then I also have, these are going to be all the methods that I use. And it's kind of confusing. I kind of like what Mr. Lew did with his modeling language. And it was really great. And I don't know if he meant this to replace UMLs, but it's a lot easier because if you look at my UML here, it kind of, I don't know if you just, if you knew nothing about my Husky tech player if you could walk in and understand what I'm doing here. But Mr. Lew's stuff is a little bit better, so let's take a look at it. All right, here's Mr. Lew's class model. All right, and I'm going to write this on the board in a second here. And it has to do with his My Song class. All right, so if you look at his My Song, you have three things. Okay, so you have the big three. There's three things inside the big three. We know that. But you have three things inside a class. So for My Song, you have the big three, the dynamic duo, which is what he called the getter and the setter. And then you have the third thing, which is the brain. Okay, now if you look at this, and if you're my CSP class, you see that this algorithmic processing, this was what he called the brain. So you could write 1 through 5, you know, without even knowing what the program does. The money player, in fact, let's go back to my Mickey Mouse drawing. The money player was a person that came up with the mouse. If you were just copying the mouse over and over and creating what was called tweens, you didn't get paid that much. There was a lot of criticism of Walt Disney that he didn't pay his people very well, but he paid the original creators a lot of money, and the tweeners who were just copying an idea, they didn't get paid as much. And that's where that argument comes from. Here, if you just do the big three and the dynamic duo, those are easy. It's just variable constructors to strings, getter, et cetera. Those are the easy ones. But the big brain piece is that processor piece, that method that actually takes data and manipulates it and turns it into something that's usable. Okay? So that's what we want to talk about today. Let me see. I thought there was something else I wanted to show you before I got going here. One of the first models that Mr. Lew created is just the fundamentals. So if you're going to write code, you should know these fundamental structures. Okay, primitive structures, control structures, and this is for Java, but it's the same for JavaScript or Python. You should know the fundamental language. And when you take the AP test in computer science A, boy, that brain piece, that brain algorithmic procedure is going to use arrays. And remember, to find out how big array is, you do dot length. And if it's going to also use ArrayList, which we learned that you could use a for each loop. So you should study how to create an array, how to fill array, and how to loop through it using the for loops. Those are the big ones. All right. So, but let's stick with the UML for the class model. All right. So I'm going to draw stuff out here. And let me make sure I got the right pen out. And all right. So the big three. Instance variables, real easy. So here's instance variables, okay, for this class. Oops, that just erased. Why is that erasing? No one knows why this is erasing. I'm going back into Flash. This is a program I used to use to draw the mouse, but it's now erasing. I feel like something's in the way here. Huh, that's really weird. Okay, so let me see if I could go to my... Let me see if I could correct this pen here. Classic brush fill, yeah, something like that. Let's see if I just change it. Does that help me out? It seems to be disappearing. It's almost like as if the timeline is locked. So let me go up here and see if I can unlock it. I might not even be on the right timeline. Let's see if I am. Here's the timeline. And let me bring this up to where I can see it. There we go. So let me change the brush color. It's now on black. Let's make it red. Does that stay? Yeah. Oh, no, it doesn't. It doesn't stay. Well, maybe it's best it doesn't stay so it doesn't get so messy. All right. So let's see. We're going to talk about instance variables. And as in My Song, you see here are the instance variables. They're private. We declare the type they are and then the name. All right, here are the constructors. There's a no argument constructor, and then there's a for argument constructor here. Okay, all this can be done without even turning on your computer. Okay, the toString method is down here. I feel like this timeline is blocking what I'm trying to show you, so I'm going to turn that off. Here is the toString method down here. All right, so those are the big three, and you see in My Song it has the big three. And then the dynamic duo, the setters and getters. You don't really need a lot. You don't need a computer to write your setters. We're going to set the title of the song, and then we're going to set the getter of the song. Okay? So those are really easy. All right? And so these part for the AP Computer Science A test are probably not going to be tested as much. They're probably going to give you those. They're going to write this stuff like this, and then they're going to tell you to write some kind of brain method, okay? Some kind of processor method. And if you looked, this isn't in here, all right? And this is actually in our student.java file, okay, that we did in the, all right? So let's try to go on to that file now and let you see it. And then we'll write it up on the board. So this will be the big piece about the CSA test. You will have to write this processor method. You'll have to be good at taking data, manipulating it, and then passing it on through. All right, and usually you're gonna do it in a class. All right, this is no different. This is actually where my classes between CSP and my intro to computer science, this is where they differ. We don't talk about classes in JavaScript or in our CSP class, and we don't talk about classes as much in my Python class either. Though both those languages have classes, we don't even mention classes. We don't mention classes until you get to CSA. So it's all the same stuff, but we introduce classes. All right, so I have 79 cents left in my AWS account. You guys, make sure you have some money left in your account. All right, and so if I go Cloud9, all right, and it should open up the environment that we've been coding in so far. Now I want to show you, so since this is a Cloud9 lecture too, and everybody could use Cloud9, I hopefully you guys have tried it out. It's a great IDE. I think we'll probably use it in the future instead of some of the other stuff. I don't want to break from your videos that you're doing through Code Sculptor and some of your through Scratch or processing, or I forgot what the CSA is using. Repill it. But this is a great place to start, especially if you're going to write any code for an AWS project. It's good just to be right into the Cloud9. All right. So I actually have this code open right here. So we could actually go over it right here, but I want to show you how to export. Since I'm getting so low in funds for my Cloud9 or for my AWS environment, I want to show you, because I'm like, I don't want to lose all that code I wrote. So look at all these. If you look over here, here's all the code I wrote, and I didn't want to lose it. So what Code9 lets you do is go to File, and you just download the project. And then if you go to your downloads, which I've already done, it just gives you the whole environment in a zip file right here. Isn't that great? So make sure that Code9 has a great way of saving all your files. So if you run out of money, all your files aren't locked up. All right. But what I want to do now is show you the student.java. I wrote two processor methods, two brains, during this process of showing you guys Code9. All right. The first one was in student file, where actually I create a student. Actually, let's go before that. I actually showed you that I created an array called class grades. All right. And it's a double. And if you go to the student driver, you see I filled that array with these values, 4.0, 4.0, 3.5. All right. And then if you go down here, this was the only file to start that I did a processor method, and it was called calc.gpa. So remember, if you're going to return something, it has to have a double here. You have to tell what type of data you're going to return. And then I named it calc.gpa. And then I'm going to go back into here because I think this one shows it larger. Okay. And someone wants to join the meeting named Jennifer Wan. Anna, should I let someone from outside enter? Let me turn up. I can't hear you. Hold on.
On this class, don't let her in.
Yeah, it said someone named Jennifer Wan, which is outside cbuc.org, wants to join this meeting.
I wouldn't, because it's definitely possible it's somebody else.
All right, good call. Okay, sorry, Jennifer Wan. I'm going to deny that entry into that class. Again, if you're just picking up now, we are actually doing a live Google Meet over here on my iPad and doing a live YouTube channel right here. And one of my interpreters is helping me. I'm glad you're managing the class on that side, Anna. Thank you so much. Is anyone getting out of line, you know? You guys being okay? You everyone being good? Do I still have a crowd over here? Maybe they all left and they went to, I got a good crowd over there. Okay, I don't know what I have on my YouTube channel. Should I look? I feel like I shouldn't look. Sometimes it's not very big. Here's my YouTube channel, and I have two. It says two concurrent users. Hi, concurrent users. All right, very nice. All right, let's go back to that. All right, so this is the brain that I want you. And if you're in CSP, you got to know how to, you have to circle your abstraction and square your algorithm or vice or switch that. I forget which one is which. Just read the directions, it'll tell you. And so this is both an abstraction and an algorithm. All right. So let me go over this and see if you guys can see this better. I like the size of it, but then it gets kind of blurted out here because it's too big. All right, there it is. That is my toString method. Let's go down. Here is my double calc, and it almost shows the whole thing. Let me see if I could make it a little bit bigger. There we go. All right, there it is. Double calc GPA. So you see, I need something to hold the total. So I made a variable that is of type double, and I set to 0.0. You have to set your variables to something. You can't just have them at, you can't just declare them at total semicolon. Okay, you gotta actually set to 0.0 or zero if it's an int. All right, now here comes the for loop. This is the brains. This is all they wanna see on your CSP test. And this is what you're gonna have to come up with on your CSA test. And CSA, remember, they're not gonna do any inheritance. They're not gonna do 2D arrays. They're just gonna do up to array and array list. And I guarantee the question's gonna be something just like this. So if you understand how this one works, you are ready. And in CSP, if you guys write just a simple algorithm like this, you're in there also. Okay, and you can describe, you know, where's the algorithm? And the algorithm is this for loop. Jennifer Wan is trying to get in again. Should I give any credence to that she tried twice? No.
I mean, it's possible she's using a parent's account or something, but is that name, is that a student in the class?
Oh gosh, I really wish you didn't ask me that live. Does anyone know Jennifer Wan? Okay, I don't know. I don't know who she is off. And we've been out for so long, I'm forgetting all my students, but I don't know. Jennifer Wan.
She's at least in the CVUSD email. Jennifer Wan with a Y?
Y-U-A-N. Okay. Dealing with some Google Meet problems now. So this is awesome.
No, there's no Jennifer Yuan in the district as a student.
Okay. I'm just going to deny again then, I guess. I don't know. What would be the big problem if she's not who she says she is? She could put some...
There is?
Okay. Yeah. All right. So Jennifer Wan, you're getting in because we found you. There is Emily Wan in this call. Oh, Emily. Okay. With the same last name. Thanks, Jason. Yeah. All right. So this is awesome. It's awesome to have... this is really kind of a cool way to do school. I don't know if it is or not. What do you guys think? Is this what we should continue doing? I kind of like it. I think it's asynchronous, meaning students can learn at their own. If this gets recorded, then they can just pick up the recording when they're ready to learn. All right. So we don't have to be here at the same time. Little problems like that, it's awesome that they're here because they could troubleshoot for me. All right. So the brain of this program is Calc GPA. All right. And so what I think we should do is I think I should go to the board and write this. And so you have this understanding of what this does. All right. So I'm going to go ahead and do something like this. Oh, just for your instance, there is also a, I'm going to go over, whoops, I think I just disconnected that. Okay. So there's also a, okay, Jennifer, I admitted you already. Okay. There is a MyPod where I actually created another brain. And so let me look at this MyPod. So if you go here, all right, we did it right in the to string. All right, so if you wrote this in CSP, no, we didn't. We did it right up here. Yeah, actually, we did it right in the to string. So right in the to string method, you created an algorithm. And it was for to print out all the songs, okay? Right here, I already forgot how I wrote this. All right, and it's just a little for loop to go through the array and print out each song, okay? Song list. All right, so it'll give the color, the size, and then it'll give each song list, each song object. Okay, so that was an algorithm also, and I used a for each, and we also used an array list in that. Okay, you can tell it's an array list because I'm using a song list dot size. Array list uses dot size, arrays use dot length. Size has the C's after it, length does not. I think that's because it's static. All right, so let's go over to the board and write and show you what we're working with here. And then remember, this is Mr. Lew's ML, Mr. Lew's modeling language, which I like a lot. It's a lot more clear. Okay, so let's go over here. You guys are gonna, I don't know if, are you guys gonna see me? I should take you guys with me. I'm taking my Google class with these. Here is my Google class. Oh, there's Anna. Hi, Anna, sorry. I'm about to get a consent release later from you. Okay, so let's take my group over here to my board. And then let's go here. I'm over here now. And I brought my Google Meet class with me. All right, so if you're still watching me on Google Meets and you're watching me do the show, you guys have seen me do the show in class. Remember, I teach at South Hills High School. And this is how we sometimes do our shows right live from class. I have a studio at school. Okay. Yeah, that Google Meets, you guys don't get a good view. You're probably better off on Google Live. Okay, now I'm really breaking the rules. The camera is lower, and so now I look gigantic. I look like a gigantor, right? So you always should have the camera up. I know sometimes you guys don't have a chance to do that. You know, you get the camera up like that. But, and also, I also made the reference on my Twitter account that you should have three-point lighting, and that seems like it's expensive, but you should go to Home Depot and get those lamps that you use to work on the car with, and just put those everywhere. And it could kind of be cheap. If you just do three-point lighting, any light works. Light's better than no light. So if you just get flashlights and create a three-point lighting for yourself, you're doing well. All right, so here it is. This is Mr. Lew's modeling language. And I am going to, he had the big three, which these are the instance variables. And he made them like private, title. You gotta remember in your variables you have to say what type of variable it is. So this is the accessibility, so private, and then we said string, and then title. So you could see you could make your entire program way before you even turn the computer on. So if you're having accessibility problems with Cloud9 or you just can't get to a computer, take out a piece of paper and just start jotting it down. You know, what type of variables are you going to have? Okay, then the constructors. Okay, remember the constructor is public. Okay, no return type, remember that? And then the name, and it has to be the same name as the file. Okay, followed by that, so constructors, and then your toString method. Okay, I'm getting kind of messy here. I thought this was going to be enough room, and it's actually not. Okay, and then you have your toString method. So these are really easy. So you can see that AP test would probably not test you on these things. Okay, toString methods. All right, now in here you got your getters and your setters. Okay. All right, now if it is it close to 9? It is 9:30. So one class is leaving, another class is coming in, and I guess I have to warn them that They are actually in a Google Live class right now. Hello, my second period class. See you, Anna. Thanks for the help. My period two class, I am doing a Google Live demonstration right now. And if you didn't get on to Google Live right away, then you missed the first part of it. But I am writing, how would you write a class with no computer turned on at all? And this is how you do it. You do MML. MLML. Okay, this is Mr. Lew Modeling Language. Okay, this was brought to you by Mr. Lew, who I thought put together an awesome little modeling language to help you understand how to write a class file. So if you're writing Python, you have class files, but we don't talk about it too much. This is more for like a CSA class. All right, so the getters and setters are the dynamic duo. Okay, the big three are the instance variables. And the constructors. All right, so I'm going to encourage all my second period class students, my Python class, or my intro to computer science class, to join me on YouTube live right now on the Mighty Code Coder. I'm actually doing this live on YouTube. And if you watched both, it might have a lag and it might get annoying. So it's probably better just to watch the YouTube channel. And I'm going to see how all this works out. Maybe this is just where we meet every day for class. Instead of Google Meets, we meet at Google Live. And remember, in Google Live, in YouTube Live, all right, or my live stream, you can put comments below and I can watch those and see if there's any questions along the way. This might be a better way to do it. I don't know. We're trying. Technologies are clashing everywhere. New stuff everywhere. So let's give it a shot. All right. So like I said, here is the money algorithm, the brain. Okay. This is some kind of procedure. All right. And if I went back in our student class, the big thing was, okay, calc GPA. All right. So to write a method, you got to make it public or private. Okay, I'm going to make this public. Okay, and if it's going to return anything, it's going to return a double. And then the name of it. Okay, so we called it calc GPA. All right, and then you have the brackets and the brackets. So the brain piece, if you could come up with a nice little algorithm, and usually for my CSA classes, this algorithm is going to be tiny, three or four lines, that's it. It's not going to be a bunch of lines. You feel like you go take the AP test, I got to write all these lines of code. It's really going to be just something easy, all right? And so we had an array that was called songList, and we filled it up in the constructor, okay? So we had actually, it's not songList, this is GPA. So we had an array called grades, my grades, and my grades was filled up in the constructor. We had five grades, you know, English, math, social science, history, all that stuff. Should have had computer science in it, okay? But we basically have the array. So once you get to your processor, you just understand you have your array filled and it's ready to go. Now we need to loop through it. Now when you have an array, you automatically want to use a for loop. All right, so let's run a for loop through our array. And let's call the array, I'm actually forgetting what the array was called. I think it was called grade list, but I don't know. So if you saw that prior video, and I'm using the wrong one, I actually could step over here real quick and see if I could look at it. It was called class grades. Okay, so we're gonna loop through class grades array. And remember, the array already got filled through our constructor. All right, so here we go. This is a for loop, all right? So I'm gonna say for, okay, int, I'm just gonna say I because I feel like I'm gonna run out of room here. Okay, semicolon. Okay, as long as I is less than class grades dot length. Okay, so that there's three arguments in a for. There's one is going to initialize our variable. Two, this is the big argument, okay, while I is less, so I starts at zero, and the length of that array, I think we had five classes, okay? All right, so this is zero, one, two, three, four. So I starts at zero, and it's gonna go through that loop as many times as picking up all those grades in the array, okay? And then the last one is going to be the test. And so we're gonna, or the, this is the incrementer, all right? So I plus plus, okay? So it's gonna increment I one at a time. You could have plus two, plus four, you know, but it's usually done like this. Okay, so that's a for loop. And inside the for loop, all we're going to do is we're gonna now start totaling those grades that are inside this array. And remember, it was like, 4.0, 4.0, 3.5, and then a 2.0 and a 2.0. So we want to total all those up. So we need a variable or a container to hold all the variables. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a new variable. All right. And so we first got to say what type is it. And I'm going to call it total. All right, and then I have to set it equal to 0.0. All right, so now I have something to tally it with. So as it's going through, it's gonna set total to 0.0. I feel like that's gonna give a problem because if I do that, every time it comes through loops, it's gonna set it back to 0.0.0. So it's good to actually instantiate this over here, okay? So let's not do that here. All right, there we go. So we're going to do the double total over here, okay? And let me erase this. All right, so there now I have a variable to help me manipulate all this data coming in. All right, so what's going to happen every time we loop through? We're just going to go total plus equals class grades index I. Okay, so this goes every time I changes from 0 to 1 to 2, it finds out what's in that array and it adds it to total. This is shorthand, remember? Okay, and there it is. And then what we want to do at the end is we want to go ahead and, okay, so that's the for loop. That's the whole for loop. That's the big brain piece, okay, that for public double calc GPA, that's what you'd have to write for the CSA test. That's the big money thing, okay? So now we, to get the GPA, we have to divide by how many classes there are. So outside the loop, we're now going to say total divide equals by the okay, so class length would be how many grades we have in the total. We'll just divide it, and once we do that, then we will have the length. I feel like we don't have, basically says is total equals total divided by grade length. And so that should come up with our GPA. All right. And the last thing we have to do is return. Remember, since we have it, this is a double, it has to return a double, and total is a double. Okay. So that brain trust right there is the brain, the money shot, and the AP question. Okay. That's a free response question. That's a perfect type of free response question you have. You'll have to loop through an array or array list, and you got to be able to use a for loop to do that. And so if you understand that, you're going to nail the AP test. Okay, so Mr. Lew's modeling language, just remember big three, dynamic duo, and the brain. And the most chances they're going to give you this, and they're going to give you that, because it almost takes no brains to do it. You know, getters and setters, you can do it no problem. Remember, getters have a return type, and setters are void. Okay, if they have you write a getter, setter, I don't think they will have you do that, but maybe, maybe. All right, and so this is something that you will have to get your head around if you're taking the AP Computer Science A test. And if you're in Computer Science CSP, this right here, this whole thing is, I don't know how much room I have, an algorithm. And an abstraction. Okay, perfect. Perfectly done. And that's what I wanted to get to. So let's go back over to the other side and finish this up. I'm looking at my class here, my second period class. How many people do I have in here? Do I have questions in here? I feel like I do. No, I don't. I actually have 22 people. Hey guys, how you doing? You guys are in the middle of a live Mighty Code Coder. And so don't forget to go to my YouTube channel. You see me live, and I think I'll be lagging a little bit. So pick one or the other. And I want to kind of test this out, because maybe this is just where we meet. We meet on YouTube Live instead of Google Meets. Okay? So we'll figure that out later. Let's see. I feel like I have a question coming in. Guess you can say that. Okay. Thanks, Albert. Albert just said, I guess you can say that. I'm not sure what we're guessing or what we're saying. All right, so let me switch back over. Google Meet people, I'm taking you with me. Okay, so here we go. Come on over. Let's switch back over. All right, so you guys are Google Meet. My Google Meet class is getting a little bit of a behind the scenes look at the show. But they've seen it many times. I've actually broadcast live from my class in front of them, and so they know how all this is done. It's a little different situation in it. I'm just in my carport in my garage. Okay, so you see how it's all set up now. You see how it all works. They see how it all works. See, there's my green screen, and then here's all my stuff. All right, all stuffed. I have both studios all in one little corner. Okay. So, let's see if there's anything else that I want to go over before we stop. I kind of feel like we should stop both the Google Meetup and the Google Live all at the same time. So here's the class model that Mr. Lew put together, that it looks a little better than my board over there. And remember, he did not do the process about. Let's actually go back to the code and see if I coded that correctly. I think I did. I'm looking at it. Here it is. And there it is. I think I got it right. Did I get it right? Yeah. Looks like I remembered it correctly. All right. And got it right. Yeah. You got to make sure that you declare this variable outside the for loop, or it's going to just keep on making it 0.0. You make those errors. You'll make those errors, and then you'll never make them again. But that's it. You know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 lines of code, and that's a real typical AP question, just 5 lines of code. So you don't have to do all this writing of code. Okay. So if I don't have any questions, let's go to my Google Live account and see if I have questions over there. Okay, I'm not seeing. Actually, I didn't say anything in my live stream, so maybe they don't think I'm there. So let me. I always like to try to put something like, "Welcome from the Mighty Code Coder." Okay, so there's that, and. Let's go over to this, and then you see this code, and that's it. And that's pretty much all there is. Okay, so let's see if I could sign off on time. Okay, so here is my sign off, my usual sign off. Okay, hope that you enjoyed it. Remember, always trying to make you great and help you innovate. So until next time, what, Paul? Oh yeah, I forgot. If you have any questions, you can leave comments below. And if you want to get a hold of me on the website, you can go to www.themightycodecoder.com or find me on Twitter at @mightycodecoder. And I'm adding this move right here, or email me right there, info@themightycodecoder.com. Okay, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Peace. AJ.